Hi, my name is Monty Harper, and this is a video about a song I wrote called Super Scientist. I want to start off by having you meet the amazing person who inspired this song.
I'm Mariana Patrauchan, and I'm a microbiologist, and I work at Oklahoma State University, Department of Microbiology and Molecular Genetics. I have a family. I have a husband and a wonderful 8-year-old daughter, which we try to spend a lot of time together when I can. I really love art. I love music. Every chance I have a chance to go and listen to the music, all kind, you know, different types of music, classical music, rock music. My husband is a rock musician. I really enjoy it. These things are very important in life because they give you strength, they give you energy that you can then spend on something as important as science.
Dr. Patrauchan is studying bacteria called Pseudomonas aeruginosa.
Pseudomonas aeruginosa.
We're working with the bacterium which is called Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Normally this bacterium is harmless. It can grow in soil, in water, on plants, it can be even on your hands and will not do anything bad to you. However, in situations like cystic fibrosis disease, Pseudomonas aeruginosa becomes very dangerous. It grows as a biofilm, covers itself with the extracellular polymer, and becomes very resistant to all kinds of antibiotics we can use to try to kill it.
Dr. Patrauchan is looking for those few key proteins that make Pseudomonas aeruginosa bacteria turn deadly in the lungs of cystic fibrosis patients. Let's take a closer look at her process.
She wants to stop them forming biofilms.
Because when it grows as a biofilm, it's going to cover itself with the extracellular polymer and it's going to be protected from the antibiotics that we're going to try to kill it with.
To stop the biofilms, she'll need to block their signal.
And the idea is that that secret signal is high concentration of calcium that is present in cystic fibrosis lungs.
To block the signal, she'll need to know the pathway.
So every pathway involves a few players, a few proteins. They work as a team. They pass the signal from one protein to another protein.
To know the pathway, she'll need to find the proteins.
So that we need to screen what proteins would respond to high calcium and be synthesized at high abundance at the presence of high calcium.
Find the proteins.
We're testing about 15 different candidates that we think are responsible for the response to calcium.
Knocking out one gene each time to form a mutant DNA spike.
To be able to test whether or not that protein is a part of the single transduction pathway, we need to remove the gene that encodes for that protein and test the mutant for its ability to grow as a biofilm in response to calcium.
While each test takes 6 months to do.
Okay, so to just remove the gene from the genome, it may take, if it works, it may take from 3 to 4 weeks. But then you will need to construct a mutant that will have that gene provided on the plasmid so you will have a control. That may take another 2 or 3 weeks. And then you have a set of tests that you need to run for all kinds of virulent factors that Pseudomonas aeruginosa has. And that may take a month, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Dedication, perseverance, and patience see her through.
Number one is real passion about research. We might be able to stop Pseudomonas aeruginosa from making biofilm and become so virulent and cause death in cystic fibrosis patients. Superpower, not really, but the ability to focus on the target, the ability to concentrate on it, the ability to keep your cool head as you're doing rounds and rounds and rounds and rounds of research.
Dr. Patrauchan has made some progress since I last talked to her about her work. She's found one key protein that works inside the cell, and now she's looking at the cell membrane to see if she could figure out which protein there is responsible for starting the reaction.
So if you imagine a cell, it's covered by a membrane and calcium is present outside of the membrane. So there must be some membrane proteins that will be able to sense calcium first and then transduce the signal towards the cytosol, where we have a set of proteins that will be able to bind calcium, and then there will be a link to some downstream processes. Trying to work as hard as possible to make progress, as much progress as possible, that this type of work can take years.
And you are?
A super scientist!
Yes!
I know she gets embarrassed when I call her a super scientist, but the song is really about cheering on every scientist who puts their heart and soul into their work, trying to make the world a better, safer place for us humans.
Go, super scientist, go. Break that code. Go, super scientist, go. Find your answer. Do the things you need to do to make the data speak to you. Go, super scientist, go. Change the
absolutely. I totally love this song. I mean, honestly, it was a great song. It is a great song. I cannot call myself a super scientist, but when I heard this song the first time, I was so inspired. You know, the words like, go super scientist, go, break the code, do your work, get the answers, and it's so inspiring. So a few days in a row when I was in a quite a bad mood about the negative results, I would just turn on this song and I would listen to it and I think, I can do everything. I just go all these negative results and the next time we'll get some positive results and we'll get closer to what we're trying to understand. So it was very inspiring.
Super Scientist is one of several songs that I hope to record for a brand new CD called Songs from the Science Frontier. I'm raising the money to record the CD right now at Kickstarter.com. You can look me up there, or you can find a link on my website at MontyHarper.com. Thanks for your support.